Hey, what's going on everyone? Jake here with Venter Visuals, and today I am so excited to show you guys some super dope paper effects in Premiere Pro. In today's video, I'll show you how to create your own paper effects from scratch using a printer and paper, as well as some editing packs that don't require a printer or paper. The first thing we need to do is open our video in Premiere Pro. On my timeline, I'm going to find a clip where I want these effects to start happening. From here, I'll go about every two frames and take a screenshot using the export frame button in Premiere Pro. I'm going to ensure that I save these images to a folder on my desktop. You can then open your frames by either using Photoshop or any other printing software. I suggest trying to print up to 6 frames on one sheet of paper just to save some ink and some paper. My personal printer is a Canon Pixma Pro 100. Once you have your frames printed, move to a desk or a flat surface where you can begin customizing your effect. From here, we'll begin to draw on each frame. You can also think of this method as stop motion. Each new frame we draw on will be a slight continuation of the previous frame. Once finished, we can use our phone or camera to take a straight top-down photo of our frames. From here, I'll use AirDrop to quickly import the pictures onto my Mac computer. Place your images over your video in the same place where we took the screenshots. Adjust your still images so that each frame fits perfectly within the video. Let's nest the sequence of images and import into After Effects, where we can add a wiggle expression to give our animation some extra movement. Now that we're here in After Effects, I'm actually going to be using Brian DeLaMotta's Shake Sauce extension. It quickly helps to add these subtle shakes to any clip that you desire, and it's got a bunch of preset shakes built into the extension. I'll make sure to include a link to this After Effects extension down below. Now that we've added some shake to our sequence in After Effects, I'm going to hit Command S to bring it back into Premiere Pro. I like to add a little flash transition when I go into the paper effect. I'll do this by applying one of my flash presets from my blueprints pack, which you can try for free on my website. Now when we play it back, we get a super authentic paper effect. You can also add paint or use an X-Acto blade on your paper images to give it even more unique looks. One of my favorite paper effects that takes less time to create is by using the Rips and Folds V2 pack from Brian DeLaMotta. This pack contains a ton of paper textures that are great to use even if you don't own a printer and want some quick paper effects. To use this pack, we are going to take 5 freeze frames from a sequence within this music video. Make sure you have Import into Project selected when you take your freeze frames. Once that's complete, drag your images from your project panel into your timeline and place them on the bottom layer. You can then line up the paper textures that you want to use from Brian's pack above your images and duplicate that layer of paper textures. On the top layer, we want to change all of the images' blending modes to screen. From here, just place a track mat key on the bottom layer images where your freeze frames are. We're going to adjust the track mat settings to matte layer 2. Now when we play our effect back, we get a super sick paper frame animation. So if you're interested in downloading this pack, make sure to check the links out down below in my description. Our next paper effect, we'll be using the Whiteout FX pack by CinePax to give our paper effects a super cool look as if we were using a brush to paint onto our video. While there are many ways to use this pack, I prefer to start with picking a frame in my timeline that I want to freeze. This one looks good, so all you have to do is right click and add a frame hold. This will freeze our frame. I'm then going to drag one of the paper overlays from the Whiteout FX pack and place it on the layer above my freeze frame and change its blending mode to screen. Now that we have this paper texture applied, let's get some of these paint animations onto the layer above our freeze frame and start moving them around where we want them to appear. Once that's done, I suggest nesting your clip with your paint animation overlays and adding some subtle motion using a position wiggle expression in After Effects or manually keyframing some motion in Premiere Pro. Let's add another flash transition from my blueprints pack onto this effect, and when we play it back, we get this super sick paint on paper effect that is just so cool. Definitely check out the CinePax link down below in my description. This next paper effect is very cool and creative. To make these effects, we'll be using a pack by a video editor who goes by Creative Flow. To use this pack, all we have to do is pick any overlay we want. and then we drag and drop it on the layer above our footage and change the blending mode to screen. Once applied, I like to add a posterized time effect to my clip to make it look a little more choppy. Let's lower our effect settings to 16. I'm then going to nest the overlay and our clip. Now to add the cherry on top, let's add a clean glitch transition from my blueprints transition pack that leads us into this effect. You get this super quick and clean paper type of effect within seconds, and I think this look is super creative. If you're interested in trying out this pack, make sure to check out the Creative Flow link down below. The last paper effect we are going to demo today is using a pack by a video editor that goes by CinemaWire. For this effect, I'm going to take 3 screenshots from a music video. From here, I'm going to import them into my project and overlay these film scan overlays on top of my screenshots. From here, I'll do a little adjusting and a little masking to get the edges right. And then I will nest the frames with those images so that I can move them around freely one by one. From here, I'm going to put one of the CinemaWire paper loops underneath of these photos. And then what I'm going to do is animate these photos so that they move a little bit. I'm then going to place this effect within my timeline, add a transition from my blueprints pack, and boom, we get a really cool looking transition. And I absolutely love the CinemaWire film scan pack as well. I definitely want to give that a shout out. Been really liking using these film scans on some of my music videos, and it really helps add another creative layer to my edits. Make sure to comment below what your favorite paper effect that you saw in today's video was. I'm super interested to hear what you guys have to say. I wanted to showcase packs developed by some of my fellow creators today on the channel, just because I think the packs are all very high quality and have helped me a ton with my own music video edits. This community is all about helping each other get better every single day, and I absolutely love when I get the opportunity to shine some light on some video editing packs that I know will help you guys on your future projects. I haven't personally created any paper packs myself, but if you would like to, feel free to check out my website, venturevisuals.com, where you can find a bunch of different video editing packs from overlays to transitions, title templates, and more. I also have a free pack on my website where you can demo all of my packs completely free of charge and start leveling up your next edit today. So if anything that you saw in today's video interests you, definitely make sure to check out the description down below after this video. I really appreciate all of you creative people out there who watch my videos, and I'm super excited to see what you guys create with these packs. Thank you so much for tuning in. Until next time, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.